Wonder what version of Windows operating system you're running? Not sure where to go to look? I'm going to show you how to find out, coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, an edutainer here at IT Pro TV. I'm here to talk to you about how you can figure out what version of the Windows operating system you're running. Now, we're going to be able to take a look at this across multiple different versions of the Windows Server operating system, but guess what? We don't have to run those individual versions to show you how to do this because it's the same on Server 2016, Server 2019, and even the brand new Server 2022. I'm going to use Windows Server 2019 to show you how to do this. There's four or five different ways. We'll go through all of them quickly, but they're all going to work across all those versions of the operating systems. And guess what? You can even do this on Windows 10 and Windows 11. It works there too. Join me here. Let's take a look. I'm going to be running Windows Server 2019 as a virtual machine, just to make it simple and easy. We're going to jump right in. I'm going to show you the very first way to be able to figure out what version of the Windows operating system you're running. If you're not already familiar with Windows Server, we have this tool called the Server Manager. Tells you all the different things that are going on with the server. It's kind of a central command post where you can do a lot of different things, access tools, figure out what kinds of resources are being used, and believe it or not, if you didn't know, tell what version of the operating system you're running. Now, you can't use Server Manager on Windows 10 and Windows 11, but all the other versions of this that I'm going to show you will work the same way there. So if you want to get to Server Manager and it's not already open, you go down to the Start menu, right down here at the bottom, the Windows flag, and you could see right up here, it's going to be this tile pegged in the upper left-hand corner under Windows Server. Now, if you're like me, you may close this tool whenever you're working with the server after you get done with it. You have to come back in and open it up. So it's good to know where to find it. I've already got it open down here, so I'm just going to go ahead and bring it open, pretend we clicked on it. And when we do, you're normally going to see this view right here, the dashboard. Kind of gives you an all-up view of what's going on with the server, the health status, things like that. But if we come right down below the dashboard, where it says local server, we're going to see all the information specific to this machine we're actually running on. And underneath the properties area, the big white rectangular area right at the top in the middle of the screen there, as we come down, we'll just zoom in so you could see this. We've got things like computer name, whether we're in a work group and what that work group is called, things like that. But you'll notice right down in the bottom on the left-hand side, it says operating system version. You can see right there, Microsoft Windows Server 2019 Data Center Evaluation. It's the current version of the operating system I'm running. And we can even tell that we're running this as a virtual machine. So first way to do this, we use Server Manager, and we go in and we look under the local server area, and we see under properties that we can find the version of the operating system. We're going to minimize that. Our second way to do this is going to be to be able to go in, and let's just right-click on that Start menu because I'm going to bring up a command line to show you another way to do this. Now, I can go and do this a couple of ways, but I'm just going to use PowerShell to do this. It'll run in the Windows command line the same exact way, but I want to run this as an administrator. And we happen to have a shortcut for PowerShell as an administrator right from the run line, so it's easy enough, or right from the Start menu, rather. So it's easy enough to be able to do that. So I'm going to bring that up, and it's going to come up. Very simple. I'm going to type in system info, short for system information. And when I type in system info, you can see the command right there. I don't have to type .exe. It's understood and implied in PowerShell that it's an executable, but I can type that in too if I wanted to. When I hit that, it's going to take a moment, so be patient with it. It's going to tell you it's processing, finding a bunch of information. And then, let me just go up to the top here so you can see that. As soon as I do that, right at the very top of all that information that comes out, second and third items right there, it says Microsoft Windows Server 2019 Data Center. It kind of trails off evaluation. And it actually gives me the build number. It tells me the actual reference number that Microsoft uses for the versioning. So this would be way number two, our second way of telling that, along with, of course, a bunch of additional information. All right, so we're going to minimize that. Now, if you're kind of an old school user of Windows, you've been doing this a while, used to perhaps older versions of the operating system, going maybe all the way back, even as far back as Windows NT, Windows 7, Windows 2000, all the way up into the modern versions we're talking about, then you might be more familiar with doing something like the following. We can go in, and let's just do this right from here. And go to our settings icon, and I'm going to go to settings right there from our Start menu. And with settings, we can go in, we can go into different areas of the system. This will be the control panel and all the icons associated with different actual areas. And I'm going to go right up here to system, upper left-hand corner. And when I click on that, I can get to this information a couple of ways. In the older versions of the operating system, you'd have to go to a different place to find this, and I'm going to show you what that looks like in just a moment. But starting with Server 2012 and certainly 2016 going forward, I can go to Settings, I can come into System, I can go right down to the bottom here, and I can click on About. Let me just zoom in so you could see that right down there under Remote Desktop. And when I click on About, I'm going to go all the way down to the bottom here, so under Device Specifications. And I'll see Windows specifications right there. And I can see yet another way to figure out what edition or version of Windows I'm running. Again, Windows Server 2019, data center evaluation. So be our third way that we can do this right from here. Now, as I mentioned, if you've really used to using Windows and using it for a while and using it with older versions, then you're probably more familiar with doing something like this. Let me just open this up. And what you're probably used to is coming in and going to your computer. So you can go to this PC. And what you can do is do a couple of things. If you go to Manage, it's going to take you right back to the Server Manager just to show you that you can actually get to that from multiple places. We've already seen how to do this from there. But what I can also do back here is I can go in and I can go to Properties, right-click on the computer, so just this PC right here. Just zoom in so you could see that before I bring it back up. Go to Properties from our pop-out menu. And I just have that up, so we'll bring it back. And this brings up the older view from the Windows control panel that you're probably used to seeing under System and Security and System. It's where a lot of us would probably be familiar with finding the version information. And you'll see right here, it also tells me Windows Edition, Windows Server 2019, Data Center Eval. That's our fourth way that we can do this. We can do it there. And I've got a fifth way for you as well, one that you may or may not be familiar with. I'm going to show you down on the right-hand corner of my machine screen that I have this little white graphic that tells me, yes, I'm running Windows Server 2019 Data Center Eval. I've got so many days left on the evaluation, tells me the build and release information, but that's not there by default in most Windows operating systems. You have to be able to figure out how to put it there. And the way it gets there is by running a special tool. It's available for free. You can download it directly from Microsoft. It's actually a Microsoft tool. It's called BG Info. And those of you, again, that have been doing this a while are probably familiar with BG Info. You may remember it. You may even use it to be able to profile your machines and put that information on the desktop so your support professionals can easily tell what version of the operating system is running when they remote in or go to service a machine. And so you could get a copy of BG Info, whatever the most recent version is, simply by going to the URL. It's on the screen. It's going to be in the notes for you when you're watching this particular episode. And you can easily go and download it, follow the instructions, and install it. Really straightforward. And what you'll see, and it's free, by the way, what you'll see is that it potentially will give you not just the information I have there, but actually profile and put out a whole bunch of information. And you get to choose exactly what's there. The screen capture shows Windows Vista running, which is certainly an old operating system, but you get the general idea. And so there's at least five different ways that we can show the version of the operating system and see how to not only figure out what it is, but depending on what your needs are, how you want to go about getting that information, easily get it and even communicate it to others and make it available for anybody who sits down at the machine so they can see it without even having to type or search for it. I will be back with additional ways that you can understand how to optimize your Windows experience across Server 2016, 19, and 22. But until I am, I wish you happy windowing, and I'll see you soon.